Hello everyone, welcome to this video. In this video, I will discuss another important topic in Power Platform called as custom connectors. You can see in Power Apps, we have many connectors available, right? If you go here in the Power Apps, let me go to Power Apps. Here in Power Apps, if you see, if you go to this data and go to connectors, connections, you can see there are many connections already available, right? You can create new connections. You can point to Gmail, Microsoft Dataverse, SQL Server, anything, right? There are more than 200 connectors available that you can connect on the fly, just giving the credentials. Now, what will happen if the connection is not available here? So for that scenario, you need to go to custom connector. For custom connector, you need to have an open API for you. There are many options available to create a new custom connector. Let me click on new custom connector. If you click on new custom connector, it is giving six options. You can create from blank, you can create from Azure service, you can import an open API file, import an open API from URL, import a Postman collection, or import from GitHub. Now you can use this all the options you create custom connectors. Now I want to show you how we can import an open API from URL, right? Now if you have seen this currencylayer.com, this is a open API website, and this website exposed some APIs to return the latest currency exchange rates. Okay, so the source is USD, United States dollar, and what is the corresponding Canadian dollar and other European dollar exchange rates for this USD. So in Dynamics 365 you can see that we have a exchange rate table, and that is updated manually. So for some requirement you need to update in real time, so you can call this API and you can update that currency table in some intervals. So let us see how we can create a custom connector to this site to get this real-time data, right? So first you have to go to currencylayer.com, and here you have to sign up free. When you sign up free, it will give you it will ask you your email ID and password. Then once you create, it will generate a API key, right? This API key is important, because using this API key we will call the methods that is exposed by this currency layer website. Okay, now if you go here, you can see once you log in, it is giving, this is the base URL you can call it, and this is the website that you have to use. This is the URL. When you click this, it will respond all the latest currency exchange rates to you, right? Now let me go here and start with the custom connector. So I have clicked this new connector, and in the general I have uploaded an image, I have given a icon background, you can keep it blank also, you can give a description here. And this time you can use HTTPS or you can use HTTP, because currency layer URL is, base URL is this one, HTTPS API currencylayer.com. That's why I have used here HTTP and API currencylayer.com. So I have copied from here API currencylayer.com and pasted here, right? Now the base URL is slash, so this is the base URL that is provided by currency layer website, this one, right? I have pasted here and clicked next for security. For security we have four options, right? You can use API key, you can use OAuth, and you can use no authentication and basic authentication. For this, it requires some API key, because if you can see here, this requires an access key, and this is generated whenever I signed off in this currency layer. So let us go here and choose API key, give API key as authentication type, and mention your parameter as access key. This would be same as this one, access key in small letter with a underscore. You have to give also here access key, and the parameter location you have to use query, because you are querying the data, right? Now click on definition, and in the definition you provide the method which will be called to pull data, right? I have given get rates. You can give your other descriptions here. Okay, you can give some more description here, and this is the operation ID. This operation ID is actually used in your connector when you embed this connection in Canvas Sharp. So this will be important. There will be no this will be unique. Okay, define this method as unique. Now in the request, this is important. In the request, you have to click import from sample, and here you have to give the URL. The URL is the same URL that is pointing here up to this. You can also get here from here. So up to starting from HTTP to up to live, you have to copy and paste there. So you copy this and you have to go here and paste. Okay, now once it is done, you have to give the body of the so first you have to click get verb, because when we are creating a request object, which verb you want to use, because anyway we are calling an API, and API has some verbs like get, delete, post, put, head, options, patch, right? Now we are getting value, means you have to use get verb. Next, the URL which will be hitted when you call the get option. Now click on import. Once you click import, it will be listed here. Next, creating response. So click on the add default response. Here you have to mention your response. So this is the whole response that is returning whenever you pass this URL, right? So you have to copy entire and paste here. Okay, once you paste here, you can click import. Okay, now once you import, the validation will be succeeded. Now you can update connector. If there will be any error, it will throw error, otherwise it will be created. I'm expecting there will be some error, we can fix it. Okay, now it is trying to save the connector. The connector is successfully updated, right? Now I can test this. So click on test, and you can create a new connection. What will be the name of the connection? You can give the access key here, because this access key will be used whenever the connection will be called. So give the access key, create it. Now this connection will be created for me. Now if you go down, so this is 1 second ago it is created. I have already created last time this one, and this is another one, currency layer. This connection is already connected. Now I can delete my old one, otherwise you will be confused. Okay, now this is the connection which will be connecting to this API. Now I can use this connection, custom connector, using a new application. Let's say I'm creating a Canvas app, and I'm giving test as application name and phone layout. Now once I will click OK, it will give me the canvas so that I can use that connection. Okay, now first I will connect to the data using the connection. So click on this data, add data, search for currency layer. So this is the currency layer. I can click this. So click this currency layer. This is the connection I have just created. Now once it is uploaded, once it is connected, I can drag some fields here. Okay, so I can click on here and drag a text label, and I want to display the European exchange rate. So I can mention here euro. Okay, and I want to mention something. I want to take another label here. I'll put here, and in this label I want to display the exchange rate for European dollar, right? So I can make it blank, And so as the connection is already data is connected using my connection, I can just click this label, and in the text I can go here and write down default title, because this is the data name here, default title dot method is get rates, because this is the method that I have used, get rates dot quotes, because quotes is the node which is having all the data items, then quotes dot Europe. So this is the Europe. You can search USD EU. So this is the euro. I can specify here. Now it will display the European dollar exchange rate in this label, right? Now if there is no value, you can also use some other value. Let's say I want to use USD AED. Let us see how it works, right? So it is displaying data, but why it is not displaying for euro? Let us see. USD euro, yeah, that will also display here. It takes time, but it will display. So I can now, so I have all the currency data with me, and I can do anything. I can use a Power Automate to update any table and all that. So I can also copy paste different labels to show different currencies as per my intention, right? Here I want to use, let's say, AUD, and I can connect to this AUD currency rate, right? Exchange rate. Right. So this is how we can create custom connectors, and we can point to a open URL, which is providing some API information. We can also pass this key to that website, and we can use this JSON response for response option. Then we can connect using Canvas apps, right? Now you can also add Power Automate to leverage your functionality. You can take all this data and put somewhere else if you want for real-time updates, right? So thank you guys. So this is how you can create custom connectors without any single line of code. Thank you everyone. If you have not subscribed, subscribe this channel, and if you want to join in a membership, you can join it in membership to connect me live. Thank you so much.